Good. Hello, everybody. Photog Nord here. I am at new locations and I am photographing with a new video camera. Today I'm using the Panasonic Lumix GH2, hacked with the no adverse effect settings. And ironically enough, the camera just crashed on me and I am looking at the timer over there to see that it's still counting because I am not moving very much. New locations. I am actually sitting out in the country at my dad's house. This is his old library. You can you can't see all the books and such, but there's a desk here, and behind me I have there's tons of negatives and positives, and there are Super 8 videos and all sorts of cool treasures from the past, from his past. And what we actually thought about and talked about was to start a project together, and this project is actually digitalizing all of his negatives that is just in boxes and envelopes and in hidden away and never seeing the day of light. And we should digitalize these and make photo books or make prints and see the pictures that I have never seen before. When we bought this scanner not long ago, we scanned some negatives and I saw some pictures from 1979 where my parents got married in Poland. And it was actually really cool to see a lot of stuff that I have never seen before. History. It seems that a thing that I have learned later about my dad is that he has also been very enthusiastic about photography, and he has been documenting a lot of things that I guess he just thinks that he'll get it done someday and have them printed, he's getting older and nothing is really happening besides these boxes gathering more and more dust. So I went searching on the interwebs and tried to figure out how to get these old negatives into the computer. And this ended up in me buying this Epson Perfection V750 Pro flatbed scanner that is actually fairly cheap to buy, and it is it produces usable results. So the time used scanning the negatives is not wasted. For a receiver of the scans, my dad had an old screen lying around, and I found components to build a computer into a chassis. It does not take a lot of horsepower to do scans. So in this case, I built a computer of a AMD 2500 plus dual core CPU, 4 gigs of RAM, some old ATA drives, a really old DVD writer, things are working. For software on the computer, I have a Windows 7 Home Edition. And I may be a victim of software counterfeiting. I'm not quite sure why that is. I guess Microsoft isn't happy with me using this version on this computer. I'll have to have that resolved at some point. Actually, Microsoft, you should just do a click here and insert credit card information and then open up the Windows, because this is my Windows, so stop bothering me. with the Epson scanner, there comes some software, and from what I could read, the Silverfast software that comes bundled with the Epson scanning software is actually preferable to use. It gives you better results. I have not verified this myself. I have just taken the Silverfast software, installed it, and everything runs sort of smoothly. I have some problems with some scans not actually getting into the computer. I have some issues with the software where it will not refresh, and then when I take a scan, it just puts the scan on top of the old scan. Weird stuff like that. But like everything else, I can close down the program, open it up again, and then I can do multiple scans without the problems occurring. All right, so yeah, I just wanted to show you this place, but I guess now that we're here, I can also just talk very briefly about my workflow. So the workflow starts with that I already have the developed negatives, so they are actually ready to be scanned. I have found this down in the garage. This is air in a can, and I thought this would come in handy for blowing dust from the negatives before scanning them. And then I found a box of vinyl gloves without powder, and these I thought I could wear when I'm actually handling the negative, so I don't put my greasy fingerprints all over the negatives. What I have found is, even though I take all these precautions, the negative seems to be very dusty anyway, and I believe that it would help if I started pulling out all these books and all this stuff and went around with a wet cloth and dusted everything off and then vacuumed the floor. There's a big carpet down here below me that probably is also full of dust. So this isn't something you would find in a center for disease movie, you know, these hermetically sealed environments with suction and all that stuff. It's dusty and a little bit dirty here. I'll have to take care of that. But luckily, in my workflow, where I already have the negatives that are scanned, that I have to scan, I scan them on the scanner. They come into the computer. I can see from my pre-scan if the negatives are under overexposed, and I can regulate that in the scan before I do the proper scan. And when I have them scanned, I will go into Photoshop, and in Photoshop I will remove dust with my with the healing brush, and that's a fairly simple process actually. And when I feel confident that it looks good, then I will do prints in the end, and I will just print them to my to the printer. The printer is actually at home where I live, so I finish off by putting the TIFF files that I make from the scans on a USB stick, take them home, and then do the prints. So the workflow is having the negatives, putting them in the scanner, scanning the negatives with a pre-scan, setting the exposure after that, exposure compensation in the scanner, messing around in Photoshop, converting them to black and white, removing dust, doing the last finishing touches, and then just saving them as TIFFs and taking them home with me on a USB stick. Yeah, so this is basically it. I'm going to do a video very soon where I will take you through the entire process where I actually do the stuff. There are some cool things. For instance, in this scanner I have here for for a 35 millimeter film, I have a sort of a rail where I can put the films in, and I'll show you how I do that, how I set the settings on the software, and what I do in post-processing after I have scanned the images. It's really cool, so it's sort of a journey for me, sitting down here, scanning the old man's negatives, and finding pictures of him younger than me, or a lot younger than me, old girlfriends, wives, my mom. I hope I don't find any pictures that I shouldn't be watching of my dad and mom, but I guess he would have warned me, right? So this is a really cool process, and it actually, besides giving me a trip down memory lane, also finding pictures of myself when I was a kid, it sort of gives my father and me an excuse to spend some time together. I will be here and sit down and scan here. Then I'll go upstairs and we'll drink some coffee and have some laughs, and I'll ask him about a picture. And it's a really good project. If you have parents who has a lot of old negatives and you don't get to talk to them very often or see them, because you don't know what to talk about, stuff like that, try and if you're into photography, try doing a project like this. I imagine it will take me a year to get through the negatives, but then they it will be done, and it will be fun both to see them all but to have them in a format where we can actually do something with them, print them. Besides this, we are running a parallel project, him and I, where he has built a dark room in the adjacent room. I will show you that in another video. And in there, I'm going to be developing film and doing prints, black and white prints, with chemistry and all that. And that is another project that I'm looking forward to. I myself have begun shooting on film, and I actually only shoot at film at this point. I have bought a really cool camera, and I'll show you that also in a later video. Sorry about all the later videos, but I was actually not here to do a YouTube video today. I was here to help my dad print some signs for him selling his eggs. So just wanted to give you a bit of atmosphere. As you can see, I have optimal lighting conditions for doing video. I am underexposed, my background is overexposed, and the matrix metering of the GH2, which apparently is still running, is actually functioning as it should. So I think I will be signing off for this time. Technical stuff, I'm recording my own audio on my iPhone 5S with the Rode app and the Rode lavalier mic, which is attached right here, and I will cut that together with the audio on the Lumix for better audio. Yeah, thanks for watching, and if you're going getting into some of this stuff, you can travel on this journey with me. I'm not a professional at doing this, I'm just getting into it, and I would love to share experiences with people doing the same stuff as I am. Great, so thanks for watching. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up down below. Normally I would have told you to check out my blog, but I haven't been in there for a while, but do it anyway. You can find that at photognord.wordpress.com. And now I'll have a weekend, and I hope you have a nice weekend, and or whatever, when you watch this video. See you later, alligators.